Welcome back. This tutorial will be about how to make dripping effect in Illustrator. We're going to create a vector drip melting effect text design. If you're trying to learn how to draw a dripping effect or how to make a font like it's dripping, how to make a logo drip, I will be explaining in this video a quick and easy way to create a slime drip melt effect in Adobe Illustrator. Let's open a blank file in Illustrator. Select the type tool and type in ice cream. Select the ice cream text. We're going to need a bold and round looking font instead of this one. Go to font family from the drop down list and click on the filter fonts by classification button. From the properties section, select heavyweight option. Now, only the fonts are classified as heavyweight are filtered on this list, and you can select any of these fonts for your dripping text effect. Right-click on the ice cream text, select transform, and select scale. We're going to enlarge the ice cream text. Under the scale tab, with the uniform option selected, let's enter 250% and press OK. You can also resize an object using the bounding box vertices. Select the object, and when the bounding box appears, simply click on one of the corners of the bounding box and drag it with your left mouse button to increase or decrease the dimensions of the object. We need some spacing between the letters. They look too intact. Consider in mind that you may not need this spacing on different fonts. Go to character panel and set the tracking between the letters like 50. Now right-click on the ice cream text and select create outlines. Our ice cream font is now turned into an outline. That means each letter in the ice cream text has now turned into a vector image. Select the wrap tool from the tools menu. Double-click on the wrap tool and adjust the brush dimensions proportional with the letters of the dripping effect text, which we're going to make it look like as if it was melting. Set the intensity to 100%. From the wrap option parameters, detail is set to 1 and simplify is set to 100. Remember, this is a trial and error method. You will get the right setup for your wrap tool after you start making the text look like dripping. You can always go back and change any parameter you want to. Once you set up your wrap brush, start manipulating the text with downward and upward moves so that it will look as if it was dripping or melting. You will replicate the process for every letter in the text. And by the way, while we are using the wrap brush to make the text look like dripping, you can clearly see that some of the drips have sharp tips, which are no good for a melting effect. We're going to fix all of these sharp edges at the end. Now we're done with the wrap tool brush. It's time to fix the sharp edges. Select the direct selection tool from the tools menu and select one of the sharp anchor points. Click on the smooth anchor points button. You'll see that the anchor point has handles now and the sharp edge look turned into a smooth and curvy look. If you are satisfied with the shape, you can leave it as it is, or you can also even try dragging the handles to make anchor point look like more round. Let's change the color of the object so that it will relate to ice cream. I prefer the light blue color. Create a new background layer and fill it with a darker color. Bring the background layer underneath the text and rename it background layer. Select the ice cream text and go to effect, path and offset path, and enter a relevant number for the offset so that the object will become slightly larger than the original one, and select round for the joins. Go to object and select expand appearance. Grab the pen tool and set the stroke color as white, weight 2 pixels and set the fill color as none. We are going to create some shading on the text. Start drawing irregular paths on each letter. When you're finished with drawing the lines, select one of the lines and go to Select Similar Options button and from the list, select Stroke Color. You'll notice all the lines are selected now. Now go to Stroke and from the Profile drop-down list, select one of the profiles which has a sharp pointy edge. All our white colored lines have turned into the same pet profile now. Now go to Object and select Expand Appearance. This will convert all the white colored paths into an outline object. Select all the objects on the artboard with your mouse or use the shortcut Ctrl and A. Go to Path Finder and select Divide. Right-click on the text and select Isolate Selected Group. Select one of the white colored lines and go to Select Similar Options. From the list, select Fill Color. This will select all the white filled colored areas within the group object. Press the Delete button. All the white colored fills are now deleted. Select the text and apply any gradient color fill from the Swatches menu. Go to Gradient panel and change the colors to white and light blue on the gradient slider and set the gradient angle to 90 degrees. Adjust the weight of both colors on the gradient slider so that the text will look like icy or as if it was frozen. Select the text and go to Appearance tab and add new stroke layer. Set the stroke color to light blue and stroke weight to 0.5 points. Click on the back one level arrow twice to exit the isolation mode. I hope you like it. Please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if it was a new thing for you. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.